Now and then, however, there were times of panic, when they squealed or wanted to squeal but couldn't, when they twitched and made moaning sounds and covered their heads and said, "Dear Jesus," and flopped around on the earth and fired their weapons blindly and cringed and sobbed and begged for the noise to stop. They went wild and made stupid promises to themselves and to God and to their mothers and fathers, hoping not to die. In different ways, it happened to all of them. Afterward, when the firing ended, they would blink and peek up. They would touch their bodies, feeling shame, then quickly hide it. They would force themselves to stand, as if in slow motion, frame by frame. The world would take on the old logic, absolute silence, then the wind, then sunlight, then voices. It was the burden of being alive.
Come on, be polite now. What? Is it too real for you?
Way too real.
It was cruel, I knew that, but right and wrong were somewhere else.
I don't understand how men could do those things.
What things?
The things that men do.
Oh.
It was a kind of schizophrenia, a moral split.
What else can you do?
I want to hurt him.
The result was a kind of numbness. No ice, no heat. I was the beast on their lips. I was numb. The horror. The war. Emancipation is a fantasy.
Roger!
Policies of prison have been overcome.
That's not for you, a garden of evil.